You're watching your local news leader. This is WCIA 3 News at 5.
The only safe computers, one that you've hit with a sledgehammer, unplugged it, and buried it in your backyard.
Cybersecurity is a risk that's been multiplying for years, and you may be a target. The FBI says there were at least a million attacks last year at a cost of $7 billion to governments, business owners, and everyday people. Thanks for joining us tonight. I'm McLeod Hageman.
And I'm Jennifer Roscoe. There was a strategy update at the FBI Springfield headquarters today. The special agent in charge says Illinois ranks fifth in the nation for the most victims of cyber attacks. Our Target 3 investigative reporter, Renee Cooper, is live in our Springfield newsroom. So, Renee, what groups are these hackers targeting?
Well, Jennifer, the industry hit hardest in the last year was the healthcare industry. Reason being, stolen medical records are worth a lot more than someone's credit card information, per se. And that's a big reason that hackers are wanting your private information is to then sell it on the dark web, which is the more untraceable underbelly of the internet that's often used for illegal activity. Dave Johnson, now he's the IT, Central Illinois IT president, he says a stolen credit card is worth about $5 on the dark web. And medical records could actually sell for up to $1,000 because they often include birthdays, addresses, and social security numbers. Now, Johnson says hospitals are becoming more vigilant, but you can protect yourself by only giving out personal information when that's absolutely necessary.
I think everyone has been in a healthcare room and you're asked to fill out the new patient form and there's a spot for a social security number. There is never a reason to give your social security number to a medical facility or hospital. They should not have that even on their form. And what's interesting, if you ask them like why you need it, they're never going to be able to give you an answer.
There are certain situations where you'd have to provide information like that, like when applying for financial loans. But Special Agent in Charge David Nann says a medical facility using social security numbers as a system for internal patient tracking is not enough reason given the risk. Now, these attacks on our computer systems do happen from inside the U.S. Some are even coming from teenagers in basements. But the vast majority of them, Nann says, are foreign bad actors, primarily coming from Russia or Iran. And the lion's share of these attacks are coming out of China. Coming up at 6, how a network of tens of thousands of private citizens have teamed up with the FBI as informants in the cybersecurity fight, and more on cyber hygiene, some advice for those at home. Live in Springfield, Renee Cooper, WCIA 3, your local news leader.
The pandemic changed a lot of things, including the cybersecurity landscape. Businesses moved employees home, and there was a shift from one more secure network to dozens, hundreds, or thousands of home networks, each a potential target for a cyber attack. Investigative reporter Renee Cooper is live in our Springfield newsroom tonight. So, Renee, what are these hackers looking for?
Well, Jessica, there's a lot of different reasons, and it's not always about stealing money. Cyber specialists say they often want to gain access to your computer to use it for something illegal. That way, that crime is not then traced back to the criminal. But they could be picking up your credit card information along the way. This was all part of the cybersecurity strategy update from the FBI in Springfield today. The special agent in charge met with leaders of InfraGuard. That's a network of tens of thousands of private sector members who have teamed up as cyber threat informants to the FBI. Seeing how it greatly expands the pool of people with access to FBI intel, I asked, how much personal information are these InfraGuard members entrusted with?
We have zero access to that. It's much more this ransomware that you're fighting, Dave. We think this is coming from an advanced persistent threat out of China. This is the name of the organization. These are the indications that it is that group. So it's intelligence. It's not private personal information.
InfraGuard members do pass an FBI background check, and they're typically people who have worked in cybersecurity or in critical infrastructure fields like healthcare, banking, or other data-related professions. Now, the best at-home protections are things like keeping up with computer software updates, using complex and different passwords, and I know you know about those rather burdensome multi-factor authentication services. Now, cyber experts say that on top of the passwords will actually protect against 90% of threats. I'll have a few more tips for you online. For now, back to you.
All right, Renee, thank you.